Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Learn How, and in today's video I'm gonna show you that how you can install Kali Linux dual boot with Windows. So you're gonna need a pen drive for this, approximately of 8 GB or something. So first you need to go to the browser and you have to search download Kali Linux. So as you can see, I'm going to the official website of Kali Linux. So here you will get two options. First one is installer images and the second one is for the virtual machine, but I'm going to download an ISO file. So here you will get full installer, weekly, net installer or everything. So I'm gonna install the complete package, complete offline package. So I'm gonna download this one. So first you need to check your system, that if your system supports 32-bit, so you have to download the 32-bit version. But if your system supports 64-bit, you have to download the 64-bit version. So as you can see, my system supports 64-bit. So I'm gonna download the 64-bit ISO image file. So I have already downloaded the file. I'm not gonna download that again. So another app you have to download is Rufus to create a bootable pen drive. So just go to the official website of Rufus and download the standard version. So after downloading Rufus, you just have to connect your pen drive and open the Rufus app. So as you can see, my pen drive is connected. Now I have to select the Kali ISO image file. And you have to be more careful with partition scheme. If your hard drive or SSD is GPT type, you have to select GPT. But if it's MBR, you have to select MBR. So let me show you that how you can check. Just search for disk management and right click on the disk in which you want to install your Kali. So just go to properties and go to volume, and here you can see in my case it's GPT, so I'm gonna select the GPT. So now I need to create a new partition for Kali Linux. As you can see, I have 300 GB free in my e personal. So I'm just gonna show you that I have two hard drives, in which one is for Windows and the other one contains a little bit of my data. So now I'm going to create a new partition of 80 GB, because 80 GB is enough for Kali Linux. So just head towards the calculator and type 1024 multiplied by 80. So it's 81920, so I'm gonna put those numbers. So now I need to create a new simple volume and I will name it as Kali. So in my case, I'm going to select GPT and hit start. You don't need to change anything further. So another thing I just want to tell you guys, if you have two or more hard drives, you have to install Kali Linux in that drive in which your Windows is currently installed. Because if you will install that in another drive, your boot file may get corrupt and you will not be able to get access to the Windows again. So now the process is complete and we have successfully created a bootable pen drive. So just hit the restart and go to your boot menu. In my case, my booting key is F12. You can check your booting key on Google. So now I'm onto my boot menu and I just want to tell you guys, if your partition scheme is MBR, you just have to select your pen drive from here. But if your partition scheme is GPT, you have to select UEFI method from here. So now I'm just going to select UEFI MXT USB. By the way, I'm going to skip this step right now because I don't have any internet connection right now onto my PC. But if you have a Wi-Fi or a LAN connection, you have to connect your PC to the internet in this step. So as you can see, network auto configuration failed. So I'm gonna set it to do not configure at this time and hit continue. And now it's asking for host name, let it be Kali. Now you have to enter your first and last name. So it's asking for username. You have to enter your username carefully because username is very important in Kali Linux. So hit continue. So now it's asking for the password. So I'm gonna put a simple password because we have to type the password many times for using root commands. So now it's asking for the clock configuration. You can select any. So now it's the main step to install Kali Linux, because if you will do any kind of mistake in this step, your Windows will get corrupted. So you don't have to select the first option because it will contain all of your hard drive and your Windows will get corrupted. You have to select the manual and hit continue. So now we have to select the partition that we have created earlier, and it's in the disk 1 in which my Windows is installed. So I'm gonna select the 80GB partition and hit continue. So you can select the name of the partition and change it if you want, but I'm not going to change that. And in the second option, you have to select ext4 file system. And in the third option, which is mount point, you have to select the root file system and hit continue. So now you have to select done setting up partition and hit continue. So now scroll down and select finish partitioning and write changes to the disk and hit continue. Write changes to the disk. Yes, we want changes in the disk. So now the setup is installing essential system files, but I'm going to skip this step because it will take a lot of time. So when this interface will appear, you have to select all the options and hit continue. You have to select on GNOME and KDE Plasma and hit continue. I will tell you later that what is GNOME and KDE Plasma, but you have to select the both and hit continue. So in Graphic Manager, you have to select the default GDM3 and hit continue. So as you can see, Kali Linux is installed into my PC. And if you want to switch back to Windows, just restart your system and select Windows Boot Manager from the grub bootloader, and you will boot into the Windows. So that's it guys, I have explained each and everything in detail. So just hit a like and subscribe to my channel for more informative videos like this.